مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. مولاي صل وسلم
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأولين والآخرين وآله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحبه الأكرمين أجمعين. أما بعد، قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. صدق الله مولانا العظيم وبلغنا رسوله الأمين الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Today we shall be having the privilege and honor of discussing a very important topic. Today we shall be discussing about the importance and significance of sending salutations and invoking blessings upon our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam in the light of Quran and Ahadith al-Mubarakah. It is perhaps one of the greatest honor that has been bestowed upon the believers by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show and to make it clear the significance and the prominence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's most beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. Allah has mentioned in Surah Al-Ahzab in verse number 56, which I have just recited right in front of you. I would like to have the honor of presenting you with the translation and transliteration of the following ayah. Surely Allah and all His angels send blessings and greetings on the Holy Prophet. O believers, invoke blessings on him and salute him with a worthy salutation of peace, abundantly and fervently. Alhamdulillah, you have just heard the translation of the verse number 56 from Surah Al-Ahzab. So this is an honor which has been bestowed on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam alone. On several instances in Quran Al-Kareem, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent salutations on the previous messengers and prophets. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, Salamun ala Ibrahim, Salamun ala Nuhin fil alameen, Salamun ala, on several other messengers also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent salutations. But if you carefully examine this ayat al-mubarakah, you will be pleased and you will feel honored to be among the ummatis of our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. That a state in which our messenger alayhi salatu wassalam, our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam, is being sent down the greetings and the salutations of from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Jalla Jalaluhu is not alone in sending the salutations upon His beloved alayhi salatu wassalam. Perhaps Allah is saying, surely Allah and all of His angels send blessings and greetings on the Holy Prophet. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayat al-mubarakah is distinguishing His beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam from the clan of His predecessors, from the previous Anbiya wa Rasul. Like in the previous salutations which were sent on the predecessors of our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam, Allah has not mentioned that me and my angels are sending salutations upon them. And maybe when salutations were sent on the previous Anbiya wa Rasul, it was for a particular period of time. But here this is a present continuous tense. That means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending, like he didn't say that we have sent salutations on our beloved Prophet when when he was in Mecca. He didn't say that we have sent salutations and peace and blessings on our Prophet when he was in Medina. He didn't say that we have sent salutations and blessings on our beloved Prophet when he was alive, when he was in this world. No, my dear brothers and sisters, this is a present continuous tense in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Allah and his blessed angels send blessings and greetings on the Holy Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. Then he is commanding all of the believers. So whoever is a believer is duty bounded, and it is first from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we shall all be invoking blessings on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. Allah therefore says in verse number 56, O believers, invoke blessings on him and salute him with a worthy salutation of peace abundantly and fervently. That means that you are being ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are not just sending a salutation for once and you are done. No, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, it is not like that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking you, is commanding you, is ordering you that you shall be sending the salutations of peace on the beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, not just salutation, worthy salutations of peace, abundantly and fervently. That means you should be sending it as much as you can, because this is a state when a believer is in, when he is invoking the blessings to the beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his beloved messenger is looking at you with mercy, and there are so many rewards for the person who recites durood and salam on the beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. Alhamdulillah, we are truly blessed to be from Ahl Sunnah, the true believers of Islam and the true lovers of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wassalam, that we spend most of our time in remembering him. As you would have seen that in Ahl Sunnah, especially when I'm talking about the subcontinent of India, there is a tradition and a custom, not just in India, but if you go to the other Arab countries like Yemen, if you go to Iraq, if you visit Syria for that matter, wherever there are lovers of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you go to Jordan for instance, for that matter, you will feel that whenever the call of the azan is given, call for the prayer is given, they send salutations upon the beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And that is still persistent in most of the masajid in the subcontinent of India, Pakistan and Bangladesh, that whenever we are done with the call of the prayer, then we offer salutations on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this is not bidah, but perhaps this is something obeying the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the light of Quran al-Kareem, from the ayat of the Quran al-Majid that I have presented you. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, you would have seen that on every Friday, at least when the Muslims in India and the subcontinent, they are done with their Friday prayers, they gather all together and offer salutations upon the beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. So today we shall be discussing about the excellent merits of invoking blessings and peace upon the our Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. There is a beautiful hadith al-mubarakah which I would like to read out to you. It's coming from the authority of Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. This has been mentioned and narrated by Imam Tirmizi in his Sahih. And Sayyidina Abu Huraira, one of the most beloved companion of our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam, he was a trustworthy companion, and he spent most of his life in the company of our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And most of the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam had deep respect for Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhum. So this is coming from Muslim Sharif. This is hadith sahih. On the authority of Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhum. An Abi Huraira radiallahu anhum. أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم قال من صلى علي واحدة صلى الله عليه عشرا سبحان الله. According to Abu Huraira, Allah's messenger, may Allah's blessings and peace be upon him, said, if someone invokes blessings upon me one time, Allah will invoke blessings mercy upon him 10 times. Alhamdulillah. Look at the reward that you are getting out of just sending a salutation of peace upon our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. That means you are sending it for once and Allah will invoke blessings upon you 10 times. So my dear brothers and sisters, these are the blessings of peace. These are the blessings of mercy. These are the blessings of Rahmah, which are coming straight from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who doesn't want to be get blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? There is a phrase in every language that we go, that in English language we say God bless you, in Urdu language we say may Allah rahm kare, Allah karam kare, and things on so on. We say may Allah have mercy on you, may Allah send blessing you, may Allah bless you. These are the phrases that we use as giving blessings to the people. Now if you offer a durood on Nabi Pak alayhi salatu wasalam, our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah is promising, it has been promised, it has been narrated, it has been said by Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that you will be sent blessings by Allah not just once, but you will be getting the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 10 times. So that means you give one and you receive 10. So that is alhamdulillah one of the greatest reward as a Muslim, as a believer, and the true muhib of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam we can get. And there are so many virtues and merits of sending durood and salam on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. There is a beautiful hadith al-mubarakah which is coming from Hadrat Sayyidina Anas bin Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Imam Nisa'i has mentioned it, and Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal has also mentioned it in Musnad, and Imam Al-Hakim has said this is a tradition with an authentic chain of transmissions. Hadithun sahihun hasanun. So I would just like to read out the verse of this hadith al-mubarakah. Sayyidina Anas bin Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the Arabic text of the following hadith goes like this. عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنهم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم من صلى علي صلاة واحدة صلى الله عليه عشر صلوات وقطت عنه عشر قطيعات ورفعت له عشر درجات. Allah's messenger has said, if someone invokes one blessing upon me, that is like if you say Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadin wa barik wa sallim. Allah's messenger said, if someone invokes one blessing upon me, Allah will invoke 10 blessings upon him. 10 errors will be unloaded from him and 10 degrees will be elevated from him. Look at the rewards, beautiful rewards we are getting just by sending a durood on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. If you just concentrate on the words of our beloved alayhi salatu wassalam, that means that you have invoked a durood and you have said Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad wa barik wa sallim. Allah will invoke 10 blessings as been discussed in the previous hadith al-mubarakah that's been narrated by Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala. Now Anas bin Malik radiyallahu ta'ala has got a different narration from Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. That means you will be getting 10 blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for rendering just one durood al-sharif, reciting one durood al-mubarak. Allah will invoke 10 blessings upon him. 10 errors will be unloaded from him, you. That means that if we have committed 10 mistakes, 10 mistakes has been committed or 10 sins has been committed from us, or we have erred in our lives. So Allah will do one thing, that Allah will take out those 10 burdens from you. 10 of your errors will be taken away from the book of your accounts and they will be thrown away. That means you will not be answerable for those 10 sins or mistakes or errors that you have committed. So this is perhaps one of the greatest reward we as a believer are alhamdulillah getting from the nisbat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Not just this, but 10 degrees will be elevated from him. That means that there are stages in ruhaniya, there are spiritual stages for a believer, that as a believer you keep on ascending those stages one after another. That is a topic that can be discussed in tariqa, the sharia and tariqa. So in tariqa it is said that you keep on elevating your status one after another. It's just like climbing a ladder step by step. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will elevate a person who recites Durood on Prophet for just once, 10 degrees he will be elevated. Subhanallah wa hamdi. So who wants to miss this opportunity as a Muslim? So if you recite Durood al-Mubarak once, say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad wa barik wa sallim, Allah will forgive 10 of your errors. He will unburden it from your account. Then 10 degrees you will be elevated and you will be, you know, ascending the qurb of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah's Messenger had also talked about the nearness. Every single believer, every one of us, no matter where we live and how we live, we all want to get closer to our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, don't we? Yes, we all dream of it, we all desire of it, because if you are closer to Allah's Messenger, Allah is eventually closer to you, because Allah's Messenger is the one who is closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we all, as believers and the lovers of Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we all always desire to get closer to Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And this hadith al-mubarak is coming from one of the greatest companions of our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Masud. It's been mentioned in Tirmizi Sharif. The words of this hadith al-mubarakah goes like this: An Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhum anna Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallama khala awla nasi bi yawm al-qiyamati aksaruhum alayya salatan. Allahu Akbar. Allah's Messenger has said, the people nearest to me on the day of resurrection are those who invoke blessings upon me the most. So on the day of resurrection, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, you have been told about the day of resurrection, the anxiety, the trauma, and the pain and the agonies of the day of resurrection, that nobody would be identifying. Even a mother will not be identifying her own children. A father will be saying, I don't know who he is. A son would be saying, I don't know my father, because they will be all in the khashyat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will all be worried about their future, therefore, for the accounts that will be taken on that day of resurrection. So on that day, when your own mother is not closer to you, when your own father is not closer to you, when the blood relations are actually running away from you, in that scenario, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, if you are the one who recites Durood al-Mubarakah fervently and continuously, and you send invocations abundantly on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah's Messenger has said, as narrated by on the authority of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Masud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the people nearest to me on the day of resurrection are those who invoke blessings upon me the most. The most, that is the word, that is the verse. Aksaruhum alayya salatan, that these are the words coming on, not for the people who just recited once in a blue moon on Fridays, not like those people. If you want to be closer and closer to our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam on the day of resurrection, then you should start doing this thing, that you should be reciting Durood al-Sharif the most you can. The Sufiya, the clergyman from Ahl Sunnat wa Jama'at and the Mashayikh of Jod, like they have been asked, what is that, like if we want to send the Durood abundantly, what would be that, what is the limit at least? So it's been stated that one should recite Durood al-Sharif every day at least 313 times. That means you should be saying, Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadin wa barik wa sallim, 313 times in a day. And if you do that, you will be among the people who send the salutations upon the Prophet the most. I'm not asking you to read out 1,000 or 10,000 times, my dear brothers and sisters. 313 times, it been stated by Mashayikh and the Sufis from different orders, including Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir al-Gailani radiyallahu ta'ala in Baghdad, that if you send 313 times, you'll be considered and you'll be counted among the people who send the Durood most on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. May Allah give us all the tawfiq to send at least this many of Durood and salutations on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu والسلام. And there is also a beautiful hadith al-mubarakah which is coming from Sayyidina Abdullah رضي الله تعالى عنه. It's been mentioned in Nisa'i Sharif. Imam Darimi has also quoted this. Imam Al-Hakim has said this is a fine chain of transformation hadith in Sahihun. An Abdullah رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم إنا لله ملائكته سياحين في الأرض يبلغوني من أمة السلام. الله أكبر. Allah's messenger has said, indeed Allah has angels traveling on the earth. They convey to me from my Ummah community the salutation of peace. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has deputized and, you know, has ordered and deployed a certain number of angels, and their duty and the duty of those angels is just that they keep on traveling across the globe, across the planet Earth. And whenever they find somebody reciting durood, sending salutations, invoking blessings upon Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, they would descend, they would sit with them, and they would take that durood straight away to the court of Allah's beloved messenger sallallahu alayhi wasalam, is Masjid al-Nabawi in Qubbatul Mubarakah. And they would say, and they would go and say, Ya Rasulullah, so and so has sent salutations of peace upon you. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. So this is one of the greatest reward we as a believer can actually expect of. And alhamdulillah, we are all blessed that Allah's messenger responds to our salam. So this is there is a difference between sending just the blessings and the sending the salutations. Durood and salam, they should be taken into context in two different manners. Durood is something that you are sending blessings on the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and you're saying Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. So that means you are sending the blessings. So when you send the blessings, that will be sent it over to Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and Allah will elevate you in 10 ranks, and Allah will forgive you of 10 errors, and Allah will give you so and so reward. But as a Muslim and as a Sunni true Muslim, when you send salutations on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that means salam. Allah's messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, will respond to that salam. Let's hear this hadith al-mubarakah which is coming from Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. It's been reported by Abu Dawood and Ahmad. An Abi Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhum qala inna rasulallah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallama قال ما من أحد يسلم علي إلا رد الله علي روحي حتى أرد عليه السلام. الله أكبر. According to Abu Huraira, Allah's Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam said, no one will greet me with the salutation of peace from among my ummah until I reciprocate his salutation of peace, for Allah has restored my spirit to me. Now there could be a question that people, these days, with the modern education, all that, they would be saying, how is this possible? So Allah's Messenger 14 centuries ago has told, don't worry, Allah will restore my spirit back to me. That means the spirit of our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam will be sent back to him. So whenever, wherever, whatever time, whatever location, when the Ummah is sending salutations on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, his spirit is being restored and he is actually hearing it. Alhamdulillah, and he knows you more than your mother does. Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has been blessed with that knowledge. There is also a beautiful hadith which is coming from Sayyida Shababi Ahl al-Jannah. Sayyidina Imam Hassan al-Mushtaba, who heard this hadith from Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib, master of the believers. Sayyidina Imam Hassan has quoted because he has heard it from Sayyidina Ali alayhi salam, and it's been mentioned in Tibrani, and it's also been mentioned in Musnad Ahmad. عن الحسن بن علي رضي الله تعالى عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وسلم قال حيثما كنتم فصلوا علي فإن صلاتكم تبلغني. Allah's messenger has said, wherever you may be, wherever you may be, which part of the world, wherever you may be, wherever you may be, invoke blessing upon me. Surely your invocation of blessing reaches me. Allahu Akbar. This is being, conveyed to you from Sayyidina Imam Hassan alayhi salam, because he has heard the Sayyidina Ali saying that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said, wherever you are, doesn't matter that you have to be in Medina or Makkah or Hijaz in Middle East or in Arab. No, wherever, whatever you are, place you are in the world, invoke blessings on me. Allah's Messenger has said, send salutations upon me, and surely your invocation of blessing reaches me. So this is something that reaches our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. There is nothing else than you can send to the beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. That means that if you just say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadin wa barik wasallam, it is being taken on the wings of the angels and they present it in the coach of our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. There is also a beautiful hadith al-mubarakah which is actually coming from Sayyidina Abi Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhum, one of a very prominent companion of our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is about the community who invokes, the ummah who invokes blessings and salams and salutations of our on our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Let's hear this hadith al-mubarakah loud and clear, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. An Abi Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhum qala أن رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وسلم جاء ذات يوم والبشر يرى في وجهه فقال إنه جاءني جبريل فقال إن ربك يقول أما يرضيك يا محمد أن لا يصلي عليك أحد من أمتك إلا صليت عليه أشرا ولا يسلم عليك أحد من أمتك إلا سلمت عليه أشرا. الله أكبر. According to Abu Talha رضي الله تعالى عنهم, Allah's Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام arrived one day and joy was visible on his face. Joy was visible on his face. So he said, Gabriel has came to me just now and said, your Lord Allah says, shall it not please you, O Muhammad, my beloved, that no member of your community invokes blessings upon you without my bestowing blessings upon him 10 times, and no member of your community, your ummah, greets you with a salutation of peace without my bestowing peace upon him 10 times. Allahu Akbar. So when this Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were in seclusion, and all of a sudden Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam came and descended the earth and met Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, and the joy was visible on his face. He was smiling. The Sahaba knew that some good news is coming from Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam. They just all gathered around him, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave this good news that Gabriel came to me and said that Allah has said, oh my beloved, shall it not please you? So first of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking to please his beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. As he has said in Quran al-Kareem, wala sawfa yutika rabbuka fatarda, we will give you so much that, oh beloved Prophet, that we will please you. So in that sense, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, shall it not please you, oh my beloved Prophet, oh my beloved Muhammad, that no member of your community invokes blessings upon you, that whenever an ummati of yours invoke blessings upon you and sends a durood, and you know, I will be sending blessings on them, not just once but 10 times on them, and no member of your community greets you with the salutations of peace. That means if you say, there's a difference between durood and salam, as I have told you. If you say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammadin wa barik wa sallim, this is the blessings you're invoking on the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam. And when you say, as-salatu wa salamu alayka ya Sayyidina ya Rasulullah, as-salatu wa salamu alayka ya Sayyidi ya Habibullah, that is the salutation of peace, just like the way we greet each other with assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So that means salam also is a necessary and integral part, because if you want to be bestowed with the blessings, praise, rahmah and barakah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you should also be saying as-salatu was-salamu alayka ya sayyidi ya rasulullah. So when you do that, Allah has said that my bestowing peace upon him in 10 times is for sure, that I will be sending peace on him 10 times. There is also a beautiful hadith al-mubarakah which is coming here, that whenever we supplicate in the coach of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the matters that you need, we make dua every single day and we say, I want this, I want that. So have you ever thought that why our duas are, why our prayers, why our supplications are not being accepted? One of the reasons, for many of the reasons, one of the reasons could be this. It's been narrated on the authority of Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhum. And Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu qala, إن الدعاء موقوف بين السماء والأرض لا يسعد منه شيء حتى تصلي على نبيك. الله أكبر. سيدنا عمر الفاروق رضي الله تعالى عنه has said that Allah's messenger has said, supplication, your prayers is halted between the heaven and the earth, and no part of it ascends until you invoke blessings upon your prophet. This has been reported by Imam Tirmizi. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, you make supplications, you make prayers during these times, tough times of COVID-19 and the coronavirus, when you are ill, when you are suffering, when you are having troubles, when financially you are weak, when emotionally when you are weak, when you see the sufferings of your beloved people, you need something from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you supplicate you make duas after praying, that where those duas are going and why are they not being accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah's messenger, wallahi has said, Allah's messenger has said, it is halted between the heaven and the earth. That means your dua has just ascended above your head, and it's mu'allaq. It is just, halted right in between the earth and the heaven. It's not going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that means Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is not reciprocating to your duas and your supplications. Why? Because you have not invoked blessings on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So that means if you want your supplications to be accepted in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in every dua, it is mandatory, it is obligatory on a Sunni and a true Muslim that you should also invoke blessings on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So whenever, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, you make dua, you should also include Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadin wa barik wa sallim. Every supplication is veiled. Your supplications are something which are not going in such a manner that the evil eyes are actually seeing them. In that context, there is a beautiful hadith al-mubarakah which is coming from the master of the believers, Sayyidina Mawla Ali alayhi salam. It's been on his authority, it's being mentioned in Tibrani and Bahiqi Sharif. These are the famous books of hadith al-mubarak. And Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, khala, كل دعاء محجوب حتى يصلى على محمد وآل محمد. الله أكبر. كل دعاء محجوب حتى يصلي على محمد وآل محمد. Look at these words. Sayyidina Ali, the master of the believers, is saying, every supplication is kept veiled until blessing is invoked upon Muhammad and the family of Muhammad. That is a very important thing which is coming here. And it's reported by Al-Tabarani with a perfect chain of transmission, and reported by Al-Bahiqi also. And Haytami has said, these sources are reliable. These are trustworthy. Listen, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, what is happening to your dua? Whenever you make a dua, your dua is being taken away by the angel and it is veiled. It is covered. Nobody can see it. Nobody can see it. And it's not going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until you invoke blessings on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Then you should also include the name of his family, like we do most of us in Durood Ibrahim. In every salah, we say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammadin kama sallita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. So this means that you should also be including the name of the family, the al, that the family of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam should also be included in your durood. Because on an instance, Allah's Messenger has said, do not send me a durood which is incomplete. The Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, what is incomplete? You would have seen there is an example was given in such a way that do not give me, send me a durood of a tail catching or detached animal. Like, you know, you see an animal and the tail is detached, it's not complete. You know, it's not complete. So Allah's Messenger has said, when you're sending me the durood, send it wholly. So the companion said, Ya Rasulullah, what is the whole durood? What is the complete durood? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you send the durood and blessings upon me, all my companions, include my family in that. That means, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammadin wa barik wa sallam. And if you do that, inshallah, definitely you will get rewarded. There are numerous rewards for a person who sends salutations and blessings upon the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. There is one more hadith al-mubarakah which I would like to quote here for you, and it's coming from Hazrat Sayyidina Abdullah bin Amr radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. It's been mentioned by Imam Ahmad. An Abdullah bin Amr radiyallahu ta'ala anhu qala, من صلى على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم واحدة صلى الله عليه وملائكته سبعين صلاة. الله أكبر. The reward is actually increasing here. You have just heard that Allah sends 10 times, but according to this hadith al-mubarakah from Abdullah bin Amr radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, this is coming like, if someone invokes blessing upon the Prophet saying one time, Allah and His angels will bestow 70 blessings upon you. Allahu Akbar. So see, my brothers and sisters in Islam, this is one of the reward you're also getting, that Allah will send 70 blessings on you. Not just Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but the Malaika al-Muqarrabin, His angels, will also send 70 blessings upon you. So what else you're waiting for? You know, if you have not been reciting Durood al-Sharif the way you should have been doing and sending the salutations, the way you should have been doing, you know, get up, wake up, and just realize your duty and start reciting Durood Sharif as much as you can. And this is also about, like, as you have seen during these tough times of the pandemic of COVID-19, you would have seen that the families are sitting. We in the subcontinent call it the Durood Ka Dastar, that we place a piece of cloth on the ground or on the table, and all of the family members, they just gather and they invoke blessings upon the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. They send salutations. So in congregations, when you send salutations on the beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, there are special rewards for such gatherings and such meetings. Let's hear it from Sayyidina Abu Huraira on his authority. It's being reported by Ibn Hibban in Musnad Ahmad also. An Abi Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhum khala, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم ما أجتمع قوم في مجلس فتفرقوا من غير ذكر الله والصلاة على النبي إلا كان عليهم حسرة يوم القيامة. الله أكبر. So this is about a meeting when you're sitting with the people and you're not invoking and sending salutations upon the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. For meetings like this, Allah's Messenger has said, if ever a group of people congregate in an assembly, then separate without remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the invocation of blessing upon the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that assembly, that meeting is nothing but a source of dejection and loss on the day of resurrection. So that means that if you're sitting with the family, even in your house, you're sitting with the family, it's like a congregation. You know, we have big families in the subcontinent of India, that you're sitting with the family, the first family, the big family, the joint family concept, whenever there is. So yourself is in a congregation. So you should not detach from each other until you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by His attributes and send invocations on the beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Otherwise, that meeting, you'll be answerable on the day of resurrection, and you'll have to give answer for those minutes that you have wasted. So that is one more point, my dear brothers and sisters. And before coming to the conclusion, I would just like to read one more hadith al-mubarakah for you, to emphasize on the importance of sending salutations and blessings on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. This is again coming from Sayyidina Abu Huraira. Ibn Hibban has mentioned this, and they have said that this is an authentic hadith. عن ابی ہریرہ رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ عن النبی صلی اللہ علیہ وآلہ وسلم قال ما قعد قوم مقعدا لا یذکرون اللہ فیہ ویصلون علی النبی الا کان علیہم حسرۃ یوم القیامہ وان ادخلوا الجنۃ. The prophet said, if ever a set of people hold a session in which they do not remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they do not invoke blessings upon the prophet, that assembly is nothing but a source of dejection, my dear brothers and sisters. On the day of resurrection, that will be a great loss for us. Even if they are admitted to garden of the paradise, they will cry that, you know, we have done a great mistake, we shouldn't have done that, we shouldn't have done this. So as of now, we have got seclusion, we have got lot of time these days, my brothers and sisters in Islam, because the workload is lesser. We are not attending meetings, we are not going to the parties, you know, we are not going to the malls, and we have a lot of time. So utilize these moments, because they are never gonna come back to you. You'll be busy with the life once you know the pandemic is over, or the ill effects of the affliction of this pandemic is over. You will be busy in your life, but these are the moments that I'm asking you, recite as much durood as you can on the beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. There is a story in Mukashifatul Qulub by Sayyidina Imam Al-Ghazali, one of the greatest Islamic philosopher. I would like to quote that to you, that there was a person, Imam Ghazali has quoted this in Mukashifatul Qulub, that there was a person who actually saw a dream, and in that dream he was blessed to see Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. He was a devout keeper of ritual prayers and fast, and he has performed Hajj, and he was also the one who would give zakat. But you know, the only thing that he lacked was he was not sending salutations and blessings on the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam the way he should have been sending. So what happened is, like, he saw the glorious, the shining face of beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam in his dream, and he sent salutations on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and he said, oh ya Rasulullah, do you know me. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam turned his face away from me. He didn't look at him, and he was shocked that what is going on. I am his ummati, and Rasulullah has said that he remembers and identifies every one of his ummati more than their mothers do. This has been a hadith. Allah's messenger has said that I would, on the day of resurrection, I would identify my ummah more than their mothers would actually do. The mothers wouldn't recognize you on the day of resurrection, but this is the mercy of the rahmatulil alamin alayhi salatu wasalam, that he would actually identify you. So he said, oh Rasulullah, you have said that you would identify every ummati of yours, every member of your community, and why are you not identifying me? Even I have sent salutations upon you. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who are you? He said, who are you? I don't know you. He said, ya Rasulullah, I am your ummati. He said, if you were my ummati, you would have been sending salutations upon me and durood upon me at least 100 times, and if you would have done that, I would have recognized you. These are the words that has been mentioned in Mukashifatul Qulub. And he woke up that morning crying. He discussed the dream with his family, and he said, from now onwards, I will be, you know, reciting whatever the business states I am in, but still I will be reciting 100 times at least durood on my beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And he increased that eventually, gradually. He kept on reciting durood, and he was crying that, oh, what a misery this is for me, what a grief this is for me, that my beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam has not recognized me in the dream. So he was crying out of repentance, and he was offering salutations and durood. And one fine night, he just went to sleep reciting durood on the beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and he again saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam shining and bright, illuminating face, and he said, oh ya Rasulullah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. He said, assalatu wassalamu alayka ya Rasulullah, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam recognized him, and he smiled at him, and he said, ya Rasulullah, now you have recognized me. And Rasulullah said, the durus, the salutations and the invocations and the blessings that we are sending on me every single day, the angels bring that to me, and they say, so and so from so and so place, ya Rasulullah, he has sent so many durood on you. So my dear brothers and sisters, if you want to be recognized by Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, I'm requesting you, you should be reciting durood al-mubarak, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad, at least 100 times in a day. That is not too much, I am asking you. That is possible for every single one of us. So from now onwards, inshallah, promise me, And promise it to yourself and promise it to your Lord that you will be reciting Durood Sharif, at least sending invocations and sending blessings on the beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam 100 times, at least 100 times. And if you want to be among those who send the salutations most to the beloved Prophet and those who are the closest to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, as been promised by alayhi salatu wasalam himself, that you should be reciting at least 313 times Durood Sharif. And if you do so, definitely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger will be looking at you with mercy. And if he is recognizing you and if he is looking at you, nothing in the world can destroy you, nothing in the world can damage you, no one can harm you, because you are in the constant sight of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. So I request you all, my dear brothers and sisters Islam, from now onwards, because you have been doing this all this time in Ramadan and Mubarakah, because in Ramadan most of us, we have seen that we do our ibadat more than we do in the rest of the months. The strength of the ibadat, we are continuous to the prayers, we are persistent to the prayers, and we do our prayers, ritual prayers, without fail, because this is the month of Ramadan, and most of us recite Durood Sharif also whenever we get an opportunity to do so. So please continue on to this habit, stick to this habit, and don't let it go from the wasavis of shaitan, because once the Ramadan is over, shaitan will be freed, and he will be free to discourage you from doing acts of worship and sending salutations on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all tawfiq and give us an opportunity to send as much of salutations on our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam all over the day, inshallah. With the barakah of Durood Sharif, Allah will erase all the troubles from the planet earth. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the wasila of his beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, with the intercession of his beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that may Allah help those who are suffering from COVID-19 and those who are in distress, the destitute, the poor, they are dying of hunger. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon the ummah of his beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.